Hello world and welcome to Microsoft Unboxed. My name is Colleen O'Brien and this is my friend and co-host Sonia Dara.
Hello.
Every week we are sharing stories about Microsoft technology and the people behind that technology. And our theme for this episode is
Earth Day! But before we get any further, please remember to subscribe to our channel. We have a new episode every Thursday, so please remember to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of them.
Did you ever celebrate Earth Day as a child?
Yes, absolutely. I also had like a nature club that I had with my family.
Did you go bug hunting?
It was just outside like during recess in this little forested area. So while all the kids were like on the monkey bars, I was like, cool, we're gonna go play in the mud. I would steal honey from home and like bring it in to feed like the deer. We're in like the burbs of Atlanta, like there are still deer around. Nature club.
Were you cataloging what you were finding?
Yeah, I'm the best attempt a third grader can do. Yeah. What about you?
I grew up in Woburn, Massachusetts.
Lots of wildlife there, right?
A lot of suburban wildlife there, especially around Horn Pond, which was lovingly called Han Pond. We would go out as classrooms, as like on a field trip or something, and we would, you know, look for specific species of plants or specific bugs. I was really like getting in tune with nature as a child. Yeah.
And then there was like a gap and then you moved to Seattle where we can bring it back up.
Sort of. I do forest bathe every once in a while.
Forest bathe?
Yeah, that's like the term for going out for a walk.
Like is that like a glamping version of
it's like a, I'm pretty sure it's like a millennial term for getting back in touch with nature. Your mom doesn't text you, have you forest bathed today?
I can't believe she's serious.
Forest bathing?
Forest.
So awesome.
I'm just trying to keep up so that the Gen Zs will listen to us
on
this
show. If anything, your mom is teaching us more about millennials.
My mom is all over the gram. All right, now I feel like a fool for forest bathing. So,
okay, now we're getting serious.
We are, because we're talking specific calendar dates.
Yes, ma'am.
Earth Day is Monday, April 22nd.
Ooh.
Which is the Monday immediately following when you're watching this episode. So you have a few more days to figure out how you're gonna celebrate Earth Day.
Get some honey.
One of the things that I'm most excited about this Earth Day is a recent blog post that was published by President Brad Smith about all of our recommitment to sustainability here at Microsoft. Brad Smith announced that Microsoft is doubling down on our sustainability commitment and that we're taking a tech-first approach to ensure a better future.
Yes. I like it.
One of the ways that we're putting sustainability at the core of our business is through our internal carbon tax to incentivize greater change within our organization.
Okay.
We're also raising our ambitions around renewable energy. You know, we've already hit this 60% renewable energy target.
Oh, I didn't know. What does
that look like to ramp it up? We're creating a new data-driven circular cloud initiative aimed at our data center assets. Data centers require a lot of energy, so we're using technology like IoT to identify where can we scale back, where can we get more efficient.
We talk about data centers in another episode. Check it out.
Brad also outlines our commitment to water and being more responsible about our water usage.
Yep.
You know, with these same sensors and IoT devices, we can start leveraging those on campus and make sure we're being more sustainable as well.
Yeah.
There's a huge campus refresh going on, and a big commitment there is around creating a zero carbon campus here in Puget Sound. The second initiative that Brad Smith outlines is empowerment of our customers and partners with new technologies. So we're bringing them along for the sustainability journey as well. The third commitment here is around empowering researchers, nonprofits, and startups with data science to accelerate their work. Numerous nonprofit organizations and researchers are benefiting from our AI for Earth program. Through that, they're getting access to grants and a ton of great data that can help push this sustainability and commitment to Earth forward even faster.
Yeah. I love AI for it.
Lastly, we're providing data to customers to demonstrate to them that economic growth and sustainability are not mutually exclusive. You can grow your business and support the Earth at the same time.
We can do both. Come on, guys.
Let's go.
So I'm gonna be talking about some grant winners of the AI for Earth initiative. So I'm going to talk about two gentlemen, Max Nova and Zach Parisa, who are the co-founders of SilviaTerra.
Ooh, is there a drone in this story? I feel a drone coming on.
No.
Oh.
Sorry. There could be. SilviaTerra realized that we didn't have an accurate reading, essentially, on our forests and our land usage. So agriculture, big industry. It is the world's largest industry, literally 1 billion people generating $1.3 trillion worth of food every year. So big industry, and there's a lot of implications and impact onto our land, right? We were just cutting into forests to create farmland to help these growing populations, right? So SilviaTerra will help us get an accurate read how dense the forests are, what their current state of health is, are they actually healthier trees that are more robust, so therefore they can maybe handle forest fires in the coming years, any of those implications that would impact the health of a forest. They're tapping into existing technologies, which is great. Like I said, maybe drones. Satellites and machine learning to basically have this algorithm powered by AI that can reduce also this amount of field work required to understand the health of the forests and the health of our ecosystem. They're planning on mapping all of the US forests, and this will be work leveraged by other research teams. So there's a group of AI for Earth researchers at Columbia University, Dr. Maria Uriarte and Dr. Tian Cheng, who are studying the impact of extreme weather on forests. Without understanding the baseline of what these forests are, you're not able to understand then and help plan for these undervalued forests for agriculture. So it's all tied in together. SilviaTerra is essentially creating the first forest census tool, so actually getting down to the nitty-gritty for each individual tree.
Are they gonna do Forest 2020, just like we're doing Census
2020? Census 2020? There's a lot of trees, right?
Yeah, that's a lot.
If you're in need of forest bathing and to get involved with nature, the Nature Conservancy, as well as SilviaTerra, have kicked off the Tree Potential Project. Through the Tree Potential Project, you can go onto their website, put in your zip code, and it'll tell you the health of the forest near you. So you can donate, and then the Tree Potential team will go and help plant trees and improve the health of the forest near you.
Healthier forests make for better forest bathing. Yeah.
98052. Let's see what's up.
Don't tell people where we live.
It's Redmond.
So whether you're digging into the data to figure out how to make your business more sustainable, or digging into the soil to plant a tree, we hope you have a fantastic Earth Day. But please don't go away yet. We have one more segment here.
One more segment.
Outside the box.
Do you want to go first or me?
I'll ask you a question first.
Okay.
If you could choose your age forever, which age would you choose?
I kind of want to say now, 29.
Ooh, are you living your best life right now?
I don't know. It's like you're old enough to kind of know what you're doing, young enough that you're not dealing with body aches or anything.
You're paying your bills, you're eating in restaurants, you're living your life.
I think you meant to say nice restaurants.
Okay, I feel like I'm gonna regret everything in this episode.
I've been eating in restaurants before I was 29. Okay.
I just started eating in restaurants this year.
Was it okay? Did you survive?
It was great. Why wasn't I doing it before?
If you could redo this week, what would you do differently?
I would have meal prepped.
Of all things. I would have slept like 18 more hours.
That's so
She's so millennial.
But when you're busy and you're like going to different buildings and you're, you know, shuffling between meetings, I just eat such bad food.
Mm. You should try a restaurant. They have them around sometimes. Yeah.
If you have any questions that you'd like to submit to the box, please email the address below or just comment right below the video.
And you guys know what I'm gonna say. Click the subscribe button. Just do it. Just do it right now. Super easy. You know.
Do it.
Do it.
See you next
Click
week.
Click the button. You have to do the thumbs up. Come on.
Oh, sorry. Hey everyone, if you can't get enough of us, I would highly recommend subscribing to our podcast, Women in Business and Technology, available right here.
And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at our social handles. Right here.